That Vidofnir should chance to arrive even as the girl fell. Truly, I could not have planned it better myself.
Ah, good. We were afraid you might have left.
A shield, my lord?
Fit for a true knight. An expression of our gratitude to you and yours, long overdue. But there is something else I would discuss ere you part. Something which cannot leave this room. My father will soon step down as head of our house. Sir Emmerich was not the only one to fall under suspicion following the death of the Archbishop. There are some who believe my father complicit in a coup d'etat. Thus he intends to renounce his title to absolve our house of suspicion and secure the support of our peers.
Surely there must be another way to convince houses Durandere and Zamyl.
So I said to him. Alas, he will not budge. Ever since I was a child, I knew that I would one day succeed my father. The thought of it filled me with pride. Yet once I learned the day was at hand, my heart was filled with naught but dread. Our legacy is built upon the lies of our forefathers. In accepting this title, am I not perpetuating this injustice? Why should I become the next count? Then I thought of my brother. A knight lives to serve, to aid those in need. When you look on that shield, I trust you will remember his words. And should I once more find my resolve wavering, I ask that you show me the way. You were a brother to Horchiffon. Will you be a brother to me as well? Come, Emmanuelaine. There's much to be done. For Father, and for Sir Emmerich, and for Ishgard. We share the same blood. Pray excuse us.
Those were the days of promises and vows, of tentative first steps into an uncertain future. A future shaped by the choices we made in ways we could never have foreseen. Born of good and evil, of light and darkness, and shepherded by our hand. Be it for weal, or be it for woe.
Thank you. Well done, sir. And with that, I believe we are ready to proceed.
Let us be about our business, then. The next patrol may not be so credulous.
Why must you be so disappointingly brusque? You're not at all as Minfilia described, you know. I don't think you've favoured me with so much as a single compliment since we set out. Tell me, did your time in the wilderness sap you of all your charm? Or are you holding it in reserve for your beloved?
This is neither the time nor the place.
Well, call me old-fashioned, but when I'm risking life and limb infiltrating an Imperial castrum, I like to be sure of my comrades' motivations.
I see now where Alphino gets it from. Minfilia is dear to me, it is true, but not in the way you think. 15 years passed, when she was still but a child, there was an incident at a parade. A gubu broke free of its fetters and ran amok through the streets of Uldar. Had I been more attentive, I could have prevented it. But I was distracted, and her father was killed. I feared she would never recover. But in the years that followed, she showed herself to be more resilient than I had ever imagined. And when she learned of her gift, she did not flinch from the responsibility, but sought to guide others on the path. She touched the hearts of all around her. Mine, Louissoir, every science. In those dark days following the calamity, she was our guiding light, our hope for a brighter future. She had so many dreams, and I would give anything to make them come true.
My apologies. I can see she means the world to you. I did not mean to pick at old scars.
No harm done, I assure you. But fair is fair, my lady. What is Minfilia to you?
You mean you don't know? Only my dearest friend. When I finally emerged from my torpor, I learned that nary a day had passed without her asking after me. She never gave up hope. And neither will I.
Then for Minfilia's sake, let us pray that these vestiges of Hydaelyn's intervention will lead us to her.
Thank you. Hear, feel, think. Through time and space hast thou journeyed unto me, as I knew thou wouldst. We are the word of the Mother. We, who were once called Minfilia. Much time hath passed for thee since the bloody banquet, since I hearkened to her word. Mother, Hydaelyn guided me towards Ishtola and Thancred, that I might be swept up in their flow and delivered unto the ethereal sea. There, adrift and alone, her voice silent once more, I prayed for those we have lost, for those we can yet save. We speak now with one voice, one will, one word. Unto thee we bequeath the most precious of gifts, the truth which lieth at the heart of this world. Thus do we beseech thee once more. Hear, feel, think. Before there was life in the depths of the ethereal sea, light and dark did once dwell as one. But the darkness coveted power, and the balance was broken. Thus was I forced to banish him unto the distant heavens, to forever remain apart, a moon bound. In sundering the star did we cry out, and the barriers twixt planes chanced to falter. Across 10 and 3 were we then divided, reflections of the source, each possessed of a shard. Zodiac longeth to be made whole. For his restoration, for his resurrection, his servants labor without cease. They seek to tear down the barriers which surround the source. Thus do they rejoice in their ardor, in your calamities, for each marks a rejoining. Seven times have they succeeded. Seven times hath the darkness grown stronger. Seven times have I failed. The Asians cannot be suffered to continue. This is my final. Crystal's power is all but spent. With what remains,
I will return you to the shore of the ethereal sea.
Blessed children, go forth and seek. Seek.
You've had another vision, haven't you? Let us return to Master Matoya's cave. Everyone will wish to hear what you saw.
Still in one piece, are we? Well, did you learn anything?
The word of the mother? I'm not sure I understand.
Nor am I. Cryle? As unbelievable as it sounds, I see no reason to doubt her. The word's tale. No one was more sensitive to the will of Hydaelyn than Minfilia. And if Hydaelyn has grown so weak that she can barely make herself heard, it is not hard to see why Minfilia, having joined with her, might struggle to maintain her own form.
What? Why would she need to maintain her own form? Are you saying she's gone? That cannot be! Not now. Not after all we have accomplished. We were meant to usher in the dawn's light together!
She threw herself on the fire to fuel your dawn's light, boy. You'll just have to usher it in on your own.
Must you be so ungentle?
Tell me about the Scions, boy.
The Scions of the Seventh Dawn lay before Eorzea's salvation. Whenever the realm is threatened, be it by Primal, Ascian, Garlean, or any other, we take up arms in her defense, that all in Eorzea may live to see a brighter tomorrow.
And that's very noble of you. But in chasing after these lofty goals of yours, you seem to have lost sight of some basic truths. To win a war, you must be willing to do whatever it takes. To fight, to kill, and if necessary, to die. The path you've chosen is paved with the dead. Walk it with your eyes open, or not at all.
I know the truth of which you speak, and have from the first. If the Ascians will go to any length to resurrect their god, then we must needs be as committed to our cause, to unmask them and their schemes, and to crush them both utterly. Come, there is much to be done.
Yes, of course.
Tancred, wait! No. No, this is all wrong.